The book of Acts gives us an incredible insight into the life of a young church. It was excited, enthusiastic, and evangelistic. Luke says of the early church that they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine, in fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in prayer. This was accompanied by many signs and wonders. Now, this was a church that you wanted to be part of. They continued with a spirit of oneness, and in moving to the temple, they moved from house to house with gladness and simplicity of heart. As we move through the book, there were some challenges that began to emerge, which caused a high degree of distress for the community of faith. Acts 15 brings this to a sharp climax. In chapter 15, verse 1, it says, "And certain men came down from Judea and taught the brethren according to the customs of Moses." Were these men led by the Holy Spirit to uplift the church? Or were they driven by a private agenda? It does appear there was an agenda, because in verse 5 it says, "Then some of the believers who belonged to the party of Pharisees stood up and said, 'The Gentiles must be circumcised and required to keep the law of Moses.'"
Now, the problem clearly stated, in order to be saved, they said, "You have to be circumcised." The question for us is, how did they resolve the problem? Does the story provide us with any guidance as to how we can resolve issues we face today? Acts 15 verse 6 says, "And the apostles and elders came together to consider this matter." What a beautiful picture of the church. Guided by the Holy Spirit, the church came together to deal with the issue. The controversy didn't divide the community. It brought them together to find a resolution that would enable the church to live out the commission of Jesus and to go to all the world with the good news of His love and hope.
Was this an easy discussion? I'm sure it wasn't. Acts 15:7 says, "After much discussion," that was the New International Version. The English Standard Version says, "After there had been much debate," that's probably getting closer. And then the King James Version says, "And when there had been much disputing." The Greek word zeitis, meaning to investigate a specific practice or controversy or debate, gives us a glimpse of what took place in the early church. I love how Luke records this story. But there was one other thing that helped the community work through this controversy, which might surprise you. In verse 12, it says that they listened to stories of God's power. No doubt they listened to stories of healing, stories of escape, and these stories greatly encouraged their hearts. So let's just recap for a moment. There were three things that helped them work through this process. They came together to consider the matter. They listened and debated. And they listened to stories of God's miraculous power.
One author put it this way: "The various points involved in the settlement of the main question at issue seemed to present before the council insurmountable difficulties." And you and I can imagine that they would. "But the Holy Spirit," the author goes on, "had already in reality settled this question, upon the decision of which seemed to depend the prosperity, if not the very existence, of the Christian church." So what was the outcome of this council? In response to the controversy, they decided to write a letter to the church, and we read it in Acts 15, verses 28 and 29. "Therefore," they wrote, "we are sending Judas and Silas to tell you in person the same things we are writing to you. It seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us not to burden you with anything beyond these essential requirements. You must abstain from food sacrificed to idols, from blood, from the meat of strangled animals, and from sexual immorality. You will do well to avoid these things. Farewell." Based on the apostles' teaching, united in their search for a greater understanding and a passion to share the message of Jesus, these were to be the markers of the new community of faith.
Acts of the Apostles says, "The broad and far-reaching decisions of the General Council brought confidence into the ranks of the Gentile believers, and the cause of God prospered." This is great news, the cause of God prospered. We see this playing out through the rest of the book of Acts, with many new believers themselves coming to know and experience the love of Jesus, and they too then became disciples. It's a hope as you study this book that you too will discover that same God that acted in the life of the early church.